Good evening, everybody. Just another quick little programming on the DM1701. You may remember the last episode I said that I wasn't too sure if my machine was receiving properly. I got a couple of comments in the messages about setting up promiscuous mode, or was it digital monitoring mode? Unfortunately, after a bit of research, the DM1701 doesn't seem to have that function. However, I actually have set it up right. I left the radio on one night, and to be honest, I think I'd actually forgotten I'd left it on. And all of a sudden, I started hearing chatter on the BC1 net. BC1 digital channel, and there was a BC1 net on Friday night. I believe it was Friday. And I sort of sat there and went, what? It's actually working. And then a couple of other times, it started receiving messages on the Washington channel as well, which I'd actually forgotten I'd programmed in. So it does actually work. It just appears that the channels maybe is over here a bit quiet. I don't know. So I was going to show you a video of that working in a few moments here. However, I just thought I would clarify a couple of things. So if you look on the screen here, I've got my digital contacts. I've got thousands in here, actually. I just imported them from the database, and that was maybe got a bit too far. Anyway, so you got BC1 here. This is the one I'm going to be concentrating on. So BC1, this is the one that was working, and this one came through at one point as well, the Washington. I heard people talking on that. So what you'll see is in my channel information, I've called it BC1A, okay? So on BC1A, if I load up that channel, you can see it's digital, the usual bump, and I've called it A just to distinguish the two between each other. And the interesting bit is here, if you go to the digital data side of things. So I've called it BC1, it's on my local repeater. So I set up the contact name as BC1, so that's the what it actually, when it transmits, that's it'll be transmitting on BC1. And I have the group set up as RX group. Okay. So if we now go to the digital groups, say RX group, and so the receiving group, the RX group is a receiving group, so it will receive all these different digital channels. On this channel on the radio. So it will receive all of these under the BC1A, right? So if I'm talking away on, if we talk away on BC1, so I'm transmitting, but I'll only transmit on BC1. So it will transmit away on BC1. However, as I've got this set up as group, any other digital traffic which comes through, which matches these groups, will also play on the radio. Obviously, depending if the slot's free or if I'm not transmitting at the same time. So I thought that was quite interesting. But then there's times when maybe you don't want to listen to all this chitter chatter on all the other groups. So what I did is I tested it, and it works. So I created another one down the bottom here called BC1B, which is exactly the same settings from BC1, except the group list, which is this one here, BC1 group list. If we go into the BC1 group list here, only lists BC1. So this means that any other digital transmission, I mean, any other digital receptions or anything like that, other than BC1, sorry, other than BC1 will not be played on the radio. So only BC1 will play on that radio because of the way I've set it up here. However, for now, what I normally do, well, I've only done it one. I joined a net the other night, and it was okay, yeah. But I like to listen to what was going on in the other groups. So I chose the BC1A, which means it will transmit on BC1. But it has the ability to receive everything in the RX group, which is here, as you can see. It's all these. And that's why that night I saw the display change to Washington, and I heard somebody calling out on Washington. I didn't reply to them because I was just listening at that time anyway. The little one was going to bed. So anyway, so it does work. So all these settings I've gone through, I thought maybe I've done something stupidly wrong. But no, they do work. So anyway, here is the video of me just recording the radio as it's receiving transmissions and people talking. So, 7-3s, and I will see you all soon. Here comes the video.
That was quite the big group there. We'll go one more with something since beginning with Uniform Through Zulu. Uniform Through Zulu. Victor Echo 7 Whiskey Charlie Zulu. Control would like to acknowledge Victor Echo 7 Whiskey Charlie Zulu's even in New Westminster. Any traffic for the next evening? Yeah, this is Victor Echo 7 Whiskey Charlie Zulu. Not too much traffic. I've been trying to get in via Grandmeister, but
so there you go. As you can see, it's working. So, I will conclude this series on the DM1701 for now. As I say, this is only basic usage. There are plenty of other things you can do with this radio. You can do encryption, although I'm not going to do encryption because I don't want to upset the Canadian government. Because you're not allowed to encrypt ham channels unless you openly supply the encryption code, the decryption code itself. But it does have the ability to encrypt messages as well. Anyway, the next one I'll be working on doing a video on is the DM6100, which you guys have seen in the chat. It's pretty much the same programming method as this one. The software looks very much the same. I did have a few glitches. There's a few things that sort of bug me a bit about it. The cable is different. So I will go through those little glitches and hiccups I came across, but I'll show you how to program that radio as well. And I do have another radio here I still haven't unboxed, and I do have a plan to purchase another one, so that should hopefully be coming soon. So you guys, please, if you like these videos, please subscribe and please like the videos. It does actually help on the YouTube side of things to promote the videos and gives recommendations and things like that. So thank you very much, guys, and I will speak to you soon. Bye-bye.